Today we are going to start the number systems. It consists of different type of numbers, natural numbers, whole numbers, integers and so on. The first type of numbers are natural numbers. Natural numbers start with 1 and they are represented by capital N. These numbers are infinite, they go up to infinity. If we write these numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And if I highlight some numbers, for example, 2, 4, 6, 8. These are called even natural numbers. Even natural numbers are the numbers which are divisible by 2. Or we can say they are multiples of 2. The general form of even numbers is 2n plus 2, where n is equal to 0, 1, 2 and so on. So when you substitute n is equal to 0, this will become 2 into 0 plus 2, that is 2. So like this, the general form 2n plus 2 satisfies the even numbers. Now these even numbers are also infinite. The next category, just see 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9. These are called odd natural numbers. Odd natural numbers starts with 1 and they also go up to infinity. So odd numbers are also infinite and their general form is 2n plus 1, where n is equal to 0, 1, 2 and so on. Now in these natural numbers, there are different other type of numbers also. If we write 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13 and so on, these type of numbers which have only two factors, 1 and number itself, they are named as prime numbers. So prime numbers, for example, if you take a number 3, it has only 1 and 3, means exactly two factors. So these are called prime numbers. The other type of numbers are 4, 6, 8, 9, 10. These numbers which have factors more than 2. Like 4 has how many factors? 1, 2 and 4. 1 number itself and one more factor. These type of numbers are called composite numbers. It means that these numbers are contained in natural numbers only. Now the smallest prime number is 2 and the smallest composite number is 4. The smallest even number is 2 and the smallest odd number is 1. But if you say about the greatest numbers, there is no greatest natural number, there is no greatest whole number, there is no greatest even number like that, because the numbers are infinite. Now the second category under this number systems is whole numbers. Whole numbers are represented by capital W. They start with 0 and they go up to infinity. Means the smallest whole number is 0. But there is no greatest whole numbers. And next set is set of integers. Set of integers are represented by I or Z. There is no smallest integer and there is no greatest integer, because they start with negative infinity and they go up to positive infinity. So what are integers? Integers are negative, positive as well as zero. After this, the new type of numbers, they are rational numbers. Rational numbers are represented by Q. The number's definition is which can be written in the form of P by Q, where P and Q are integers and Q should not be equal to 0. Why do we insist on this Q is not equal to 0? Because any number divided by 0 in maths is not defined. That is why we insist that the denominator should not be 0. Now, after these rational numbers, if we notice how many numbers are between the numbers, if I ask that natural number and another natural number, two consecutive natural numbers are there, and you have to find out the numbers between these two numbers. We will not find any natural number between two consecutive natural numbers. Similarly, if you take any two whole numbers, consecutive whole numbers, you will not find any whole number between two consecutive whole numbers. Similarly, if you take two consecutive integers, there is no integer between two consecutive integers. But if you find two rational numbers between two rational numbers, then you can say there are infinite rational numbers between two rational numbers. Let's see how. First of all, take two numbers, 1 and 2. Now the question is whether this 1 and 2 are rational or not. Every natural number is a rational number, because it fulfills the definition of rational number. If you write any rational number, it can be written as 5 upon 1. 1 we can introduce from our side, and when we introduce this 1, then it is not changing the value of this number. So it means that every natural number, every integer, every whole number is also a rational number, but the converse is not true always. Because every rational number, is it a natural? No. Every rational number, is it an integer? No. Any rational number, is it a whole number? No. But if you check all the natural numbers, all the whole numbers, integers, they are rational numbers. Now we'll discuss more about rational numbers. How to find the numbers between two given rational numbers? Suppose two numbers are given, 1 and 2, and we have to introduce the numbers between these two given rational numbers. First of all, see, 1 and 2 are rational or not. 1 can be written as 1 upon 1. 2 can be written as 2 upon 1. So, 1 upon 1 is a rational number because 1 and 1 both are integers and denominator is not equal to 0. Similarly, 2 and 1 both are integers and the denominator is not equal to 0. So, every natural number, every integer, every whole number can be written in the form of rational numbers. So, 1 and 2 are the given numbers and we have to introduce some numbers between them. Easy way is just write 10 and 10 in the numerator and denominator. The new number will become 10 upon 10 and this is 20 upon 10. If you want to introduce the numbers between these two, after 10 comes 11. So the new number between these two will be 11, 12 upon 10 and so on. And if the numbers given are not having the same denominator, then how to find the numbers between two given rational numbers? For example, this is 1 upon 3 and 4 upon 3. Two numbers are given to you, 1 upon 3 and 4 upon 3. We have to introduce the numbers between them. Denominator is same, then you can introduce the numbers between this. If denominators are not same, then you will find out the LCM of the denominators and we will rewrite the numbers. Here the LCM of 2 and 3 is 6. So you have to make this 2 also as 6 and 3 also as 6. So 2 into how much is 6? 3. So 3 we will multiply here as well as here. 3 into 2 is 6. So 2 here and 2 here. So the new number is become now 3 upon 6 and 2 upon 6. But still after writing this, there are no natural numbers between 3 and 2. So we can increase the value. And how to do that? You can multiply the given number by any number. For example, I have to introduce 4 numbers between these two. I'll simply take one more than that and multiply into 5 into 5. So the new number is 3 5s are 15. 6 5s are 30, 2 5s are 10, and 6 5s are 30. Now you can say that there are numbers between these two. So the numbers between 15 by 30 and 10 by 30 are 14 by 30, 13 by 30, 12 by 30, and 11 by 30. So when the denominator is same, then simply multiply it by 10, numerator and denominator, and introduce the numbers. But when the denominators are not same, you make them same by finding the LCM of the denominators. And if still the numbers are less or no numbers between the numerators, we can increase the values. How can we increase? We will simply take any number, multiply it by numerator and denominator, and then you will find the numbers between the given two numbers. Like this, we can introduce many more numbers. So, the conclusion is, between two rational numbers, between two any rational numbers, how many numbers can be introduced? Infinite. Between two rational numbers, there are infinite rational numbers. So, till now what we have seen? Natural numbers, whole numbers, integers, and rationals. There is a category that is called irrational numbers. Irrational numbers are the numbers which cannot be written in the form of P by Q. Cannot be written in the form of P by Q means what? The numbers of the type root 2, root 3, cube root of 2, and so on. To understand this, let's take the list of squares. 1 square is 1, 2 square is 4, 3 square is 9, and 4 square is 16. If you just take the reverse process of this, under root of 1 is 1, under root of 4 is 2, under root of 9 is 3. It means that there are some numbers whose multiplication by itself gives you 4. There is a number multiplied by itself gives you 9. But what about the numbers between these two? Similarly, 1 into 1 is 1. So these all numbers which are left out, these all numbers, when they go under the radical sign, radical sign is this. This is called the radical sign. These all numbers, when they fall under the radical sign, they will be called as irrational numbers. So root 2, root 3, root 5, root 6, and so on. Similarly, we can also find when the numbers are written under this radical sign, but something else than 2, means if you are writing 3 over here, if nothing is written over here, it is understood that this is called square root. But other than this, if this is written, this will be named as cube root. Similarly, if n is written, it will be named as nth root. Now, we are discussing about the cube root. Which type of numbers will be irrational? Now, take the list of the cubes. 1 cube is 1, 2 cube is 8, 3 cube is 27. Now, if you look at the reverse order of this, 1 cube is 1 can give you cube root of 1 is 1, cube root of 8 is 2, cube root of 27 is 3. What is the meaning of that? The meaning is 1 into 1 into 1 is equals to 1. Or when you take it further, cube root of 8 is 2. So between this number 1 and 8, what about the cube root of 2, cube root of 3, means there is no number whose multiplication by itself 3 times can give you 2. That is why this cube root of 2 will fall in the category of irrational numbers. So one type is by using the radical sign, we can say these all type of numbers are irrational numbers. Similarly, cube root of 2 and so on. One very common number is pi. Pi is used in geometry. Its approximate value is 22/7 or 3.14. Always remember, this value is not exact. So this pi also comes in the category of irrational numbers. So in this number system, the new numbers are irrational numbers. We can also say that when you combine rationals and irrationals, these are rationals and irrationals. Irrationals you can represent it by Q star also. When you combine these two, a new type of numbers, they are real numbers. So real numbers is the combination of rationals and irrationals. Always remember, rational numbers already contains integers, whole numbers and natural numbers. So these real numbers are either rationals or irrationals. So the biggest set till now what we have seen is the set of real numbers.